हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द टॉपिक वायरॉइड्स, राइट? इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव टेकन प्रायोन्स एंड नाउ वी आर टेकिंग वायरॉइड्स. दिस टॉपिक वी विल अंडरस्टैंड इन फोर हेडिंग्स: इंट्रोडक्शन, स्ट्रक्चर, डिजीजेस एंड मोड ऑफ एक्शन. सो लेट्स टेक वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट, राइट? रिमेंबर, वायरॉइड्स आर वॉट? We have earlier learned about prions. Prions were having similarity to viruses. Similarly, viroids. Viroids are also given under virology section most of the times. And they are also having resemblance to viruses. We can say viroids are what? Viroids are nucleic acid molecules. Okay? Viroids are nucleic acid molecules. Now question comes, we know nucleic acid includes DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid, and RNA, ribonucleic acid. So viroids are DNA and RNA. Then remember, viroids are not having DNA molecules. They are what? They are having only RNA, right? So we can say RNA molecules are known as viroids. Now question comes, RNA exists in single-stranded form as well as double-stranded form. So which form of RNA is known as viroids? Remember, it is single-stranded form. Single-stranded form of RNA, these are called as what? These are called as viroids. Okay? Now, again, I am going to take the same point here. Viroids are resembling in their biochemistry to viruses. Why? Because viruses are made up of what? Nucleic acid and proteins. Right? If we remove proteins from viruses, or we can say if viruses undergo some kind of mutations and proteins are removed, then what will happen? Viruses will get converted into viroids, right? Single-stranded RNA viruses can be converted into viroids. So this I can say about the brief introduction part, that what actually viroids are, right? Now another point we will be taking about viroids. So first point is clear to everyone, that viroids are what? Viroids are single-stranded RNA molecules, right? Then second point we should know about viroids: the genes which are present on single-stranded RNA, they are actually non-coding. Okay, they don't code for any kind of product. This is the reason that viroids totally dependent on host metabolic machinery. Remember these points. And of course, as viruses are obligate intracellular parasites, they are requiring some host. After getting intracellular, they are able to start their life cycle. Similarly, viroids can do. And remember, viroids, the host for viroids are plants. Viroids are not going to use animals and humans as their host. Okay, animals and humans, if I talk about, and human, they are not the host for viroid. Only plant is the host, right? And in plant nucleus, in plant cell nucleus, viroids actually multiply, replicate, and increase in number. Okay, so these are the points. Let's take a quick revision. Viroids, single-stranded RNA molecules. Genes which are present on these RNA molecules, they are actually non-coding. They don't code for any gene, any product. Viroids, if we talk about their host, of course, they require some host. They are obligate intracellular parasites, and host metabolic machinery is used by them. And host for them is what? Plants. Animals and humans, it is just opposite to the prions, right? Prions are using animals and human as host, and viroids are going to use what? Plants as their host. And in plant cell nucleus, they undergo replication and increase in number. Now we are going towards second topic, that is structure, right? So if we talk about structure, then we should know viroids. Already it is, introduction is done for everyone. Now structure, if I say, it is clear they are single stranded RNA molecules, right? Viroids are what? Single stranded RNA molecules. Okay, this is what viroids. They don't have any protein, they don't have any cell wall, cell membrane, acellular, these are, right? Then if we talk about their structure, remember, they are of very small size, right? Very small size, and generally the size range between 246 to 299 nucleotide. Sorry, 246 to 399 nucleotides. This is the size range for viroids. And third, we should know, they appear like rod shape. Rod shaped structure they usually have. Okay, now what is the rod shaped structure? And remember, look like double stranded molecules. Although viroids are single stranded, but they look like double stranded. Why they look like double stranded? Due to intra-strand base pairing. This point I will be making you more clear through a diagram, right? So let's revise structure part. Viroids, single stranded RNA molecules, clear to everyone. They are having small size, of course nucleotide number is too less, 246 to 399 nucleotides only. This is the range. Rod shaped structure they are having, which look like double stranded molecules, and intra-strand base pairing occurs. This is the reason single stranded RNA molecules or single stranded RNA viroids look like double stranded. Okay, so this was about the key points of structure. Now let's talk about the rod shaped structure through a diagrammatic representation. So you see here, rod shaped structure it is having with closed ends, right? Single stranded RNA molecules, what it become? It becomes like this. Okay, it get base pair and shows intra-strand base pairing, right? And this type of structure, what happen? Generally it is observed. One more loop is formed over here, like this. Remember now, this is the structure, but this structure is divided into different segments. Okay, this part is known as left terminal domain. This is known as what? Left terminal domain. And this is known as what? Right terminal domain. Okay. Now the central region where this kind of loop structure is there, this is known as central conserved region. It is known as CCR, central conserved region. And to just adjacent to left terminal domain, there is a region which is known as pathogenicity domain. Okay, and just adjacent to right terminal domain, there is a region which is known as variable domain. Okay, let's elaborate these points. TL stands for what? TL is what? Left terminal domain. Left terminal domain. Okay. And TR is what here? Right terminal domain. It is clear to everyone, this is left terminal domain, this is right terminal domain. Okay. Then if we talk about P, P stands for what? Pathogenicity domain. Pathogenicity domain. Okay. This one. And then V is what? V is variable domain. V is variable domain. And CCR is what? Central conserved region. Right? So this is the basic structure of viroids, that it showed what? It showed closed ends due to intra-strand base pairing, and look like what? Double stranded RNA molecules, but actually it is single stranded. Just due to intra-strand base pairing, its ends get close and double stranded regions appear, right? So this is about the structure. And remember one point here, that of course viroids are of different types. Some viroids are able to cause one type of result, one type of disease. Other type of viroids are able to cause diseases in citrus, another type is going to cause disease in potato. So what is the difference between them? Remember their pathogenicity of viroid and their nature, that what particular host they are going to affect and giving us which kind of results. It depends on two domains. One is left terminal domain and other one is pathogenicity domain. So changes in these domains particularly leads to what? Change in pathogenicity of viroid, right? Change in pathogenicity. Pathogenicity of viroid. So pathogenicity of viroid is mainly decided by TL and P regions base sequence. What kind of bases and in which order they are present, they will be deciding that in left terminal domain and pathogenicity domain, that viroid is going to give us which kind of results, or it is going to be responsible for causing which particular type of diseases, right? So this is about the rod shaped structure with, I can say, 5 segments: one left terminal domain, right terminal domain, central conserved region, pathogenicity domain and variable domain. And pathogenicity of viroids vary from one viroid to another due to changes in left terminal domain and pathogenicity domain. So this is about the structure of viroid. Now we are moving towards, after structure we are going towards diseases. Of course, now though it is clear to everyone that viroids are going to cause or attack or use plants as their host. Okay, they are not going to use animals and human. First make it clear, no viroid diseases is known for animals and human. Make it clear first. Now diseases they are able to cause only in what? Plants. Okay, now question comes, what are the name of those diseases? Of course, plants are attacked in their host cell, in the cell on nucleus of plants. Generally viroids get multiply, right? So because viroids are obligate intracellular parasites, this point we have earlier made it clear under introduction section. Now what are the diseases of plants? So here I am going to tell you the name of few diseases. One is potato spindle tuber disease viroid. Potato spindle tuber disease viroid. Okay, potato spindle tuber disease. And second, you should know here, citrus exocortis viroid. As the name is going to, exocortis viroid. Host name is clear here, potato spindle tuber disease, which is caused by a viroid in potatoes. Citrus exocortis viroid. Then another one is coconut cardon viroid. Right? So these are few diseases which are very important and caused by viroids in plants. Let's also remember here, potato spindle tuber disease viroid, it is generally having a size of 359 nucleotides. And citrus exocortis viroid, its size is 375 nucleotide. And coconut cardon viroid, 246 nucleotide in size, right? So these are some of the important diseases which are caused by viroids in plants. I hope it is clear to you, diseases also. So this is the significance of viroids, that they can lead to plant diseases. Okay, now our last heading for today's class is mode of action, right? So let's talk about mode of action. Remember, first we should know about one concept, that if we talk about host cells, right, what kind of host cells? Here we are going to talk about plants, right? They are having a mechanism which is known as RNA silencing. Okay, RNA silencing type of mode of action is shown by host cell, that is plant cells, against double-stranded RNA viruses, right? Against double-stranded RNA viruses, plant cells show a mechanism which is known as RNA silencing. Of course, what it will be doing here, plants here will be nullifying the effect of what? RNA viruses, by binding to them. They will be making the response of RNA viruses, or RNAs of viruses will be leading to what? their effect will be silent because of a mechanism which is shown by plant known as plant RNA silencing. Now what will happen if viroids are going to attack plant cell? Viroids will bind to mRNA of plant cell, right? And what it will be doing, mRNA of plants, it will become non-functional. And what we can say, viroids, it is going to actually make the host cell gene silent. So again, make this concept clear. Generally, host cell, that is plant cells, show RNA silencing mechanism against double-stranded RNA viruses. But it will not work in case of viroids. What viroids do? It is clear up to this point, but this will not work for viroids. What viroids do? Viroids attack plant cell. Viroids bind, I can say, hybridize to mRNA of plant cells, which are complementary to that, and destruct the message of mRNA in plants, and leading to what? Death of plant. Right, so this is the mechanism, very simple mechanism. It is binding of viroids RNA, single-stranded RNA of viroid, to the host cell mRNA, okay, which is complementary to that, and then destructing the host cell mRNA message, that is plant cell mRNA message, and ultimately leading to the death of plant, okay, because non-functioning of its cells. So I hope this is clear to you all. So this was about the viroids under four headings, and remember, for this I will also going to upload the MCQs very soon, and you know MCQs I will be uploading in next video. So thanks a lot and keep watching.